after the deviation of the bipolar suspension system, so that we have calculated the moment of inertia, right, for the bar elements. And similarly, if there is a circular disc is there, or triangle plates are there, or square plate or pentagonal plates are there, so then how could you calculate the mass moment of inertia? So for this one, here we are going to be introducing one more method, that's going to be the bipolar suspension. The main purpose is here to find out the mass moment of inertia for the circular objects, circular disc, or going to be the triangle disc, or any complicated shapes plates are going to be, easily we can calculate. Right, and we do have, say in this case I have taken the circular plate, or you can take the triangle plate in this case, then we can going to be fix the three flexible strings and due to the support over there, or we can take the, it's going to be the square plate or rectangle plate or pentagon shape, whatever the shape it is going to be. So then what will happen here, see, this is going to be the support and we do have the springs and they are going to be connected to each other, is going to be 120 degrees. So here each strings are going to be fixed over here, so that's going to be 120 degrees it is going to be making here. So then it support, it fix it to the support. So then what will happen? So center weight is going to be acting in the downward direction, that's going to be the W. So then in this case we need to find out initially the tensions acting in the flexible strings. So that's, we are going to be, how many strings we do have? 1, 2, 3 strings we do have. In this case, that's why you can say the trifilar weights here that was suspended with the three strings for the complicated shapes. So then that what I want to say, that is going to be tension in the each strings, that's going to be tension in each strings, that is going to be T2, T3, that is equal to, what is the weight here? W. So we do have the three strings, that's going to be W/3, right? So by using this one, so we have calculated the tension in the each spring. After this one, what I'm going to do, I will give the initial displacement to this disc. So then what happened, I have rotated in the clockwise direction at an angle theta. Right, this is the theta, I have rotated in this direction. Then what happened, this is also going to be changed, this is also going to be changed. That means all the fixed points on this also making the theta angle. At the same time, the strings also going to be making angle pi. So can you see like this? And this is going to be like this. So this is going to be the pi angle it is going to be making. So as usual, in the bipolar suspension system, we have calculated the tension as well as this one. Right, the pi value we have calculated. So in this case, how we are going to be calculating the pi and theta? So in this case, the radius of the plate is going to be r, the total length is going to be l, is going to be there. So in this case, what happened, the horizontal component is going to be the influencing factor, which is going to be participating in the restoring torque, so that the vertical springs, that means vertical springs are not going to be that level in implementing their influence in the restoring torque. That's why we are neglecting the vertical component, only we are going to be taking the horizontal component. So how could you take it here? Then once again I am going to be taking the sine theta here, right? The sine theta is going to be opposite side, is going to be this part, right? And then this is going to be the r, is going to be there. So that's going to be, this is the a dash, and the c, suppose if you are going to be taking, so then this is going to be a dash by a c I am going to be taking. So as we know that, so sine theta is going to be here, is going to be z, sorry, this is going to be a into z, we do have to take it. So then in this case what will happen, az is equal to r. So a dash is equal to how much? That's going to be r into theta we are going to be taking. And similarly for this one, a dash c is equal to, we do have the sine pi is equal to, what is the formula? a dash by a c, right? So a dash is equal to, what is the formula? L into pi we are going to be taking, right? So when we are equating these two, we are getting the pi value here. L pi is equal to r theta. Pi is equal to r theta l, we got it, right? So then what will happen? So in this case also, the tension we are going to taking the here, the horizontal component. How many horizontal components we do have? 1, 2, 3. Three strings are going to be having the tensions, and they are going to be generating the three torque. That means the torque forces, horizontal forces are going to be generating. So here, the horizontal component in this case, HC1 is equal to, what is the formula we do have? So that's, we got it, the TA into sine pi, that I am going to say TA is equal to, that's going to be pi I am going to be taking. So in this case, similarly, how many would you have? HC2 is equal to TB pi, HC3 is equal to TCRTC5 we are going to say. So that's going to be one horizontal component, second horizontal component, and the third horizontal component. So that I am going to be say this is going to be 3 is equal to TD5. So as we know that the pi value we do got it, r theta by L we do have. So once I am going to be substituting in this equation, then I can calculate the total restoring force. What is the total restoring force in this case? So that's going to be Ta is equal to W by 3. The total restoring force, the Tr is equal to, what is the formula? That's going to be W. So in this case, the first restoring force we are going to be substituting. See, the horizontal component Ta. Ta is equal to, what is that one? W by 3 we do have. So that's going to be W by 3. Pi is equal to R theta by L. So this is going to be the horizontal component. And what is the restoring torque for this one? The total restoring torque, how we are going to be calculating? By combination of Ta plus pi, Tb plus pi, Td plus pi. Suppose if I am going to be taking, what I am going to be getting? The total restoring torque is equal to HC1 plus HC2 plus HC3. So that's going to be, in this case, pi is going to be the common. That's going to be Ta plus Tb plus Tc. That's going to be the pi. What is Tb? Ta W by 3, Tb W by 3, this is also W by 3. So then W I am going to be getting, that's going to be R theta L. So this is going to be acting at a distance. So what is the distance from that point? So restoring force here, we can say that's going to be the R distance is there. The total restoring force is going to be concentrating at the G point. So then finally we are getting W R square theta by L, we will get it. So this is going to be the restoring torque. So we do have accelerating. This is going to be the restoring torque. What is the accelerating torque? Ta is equal to I alpha, right? I is equal to m k square. This is going to be the alpha we do have. So right, in this case, what is the value of this? Is going to be W z k square alpha. K is going to be radius of direction. As we know that one is going to be acting in the clockwise direction, one is in the anti-clockwise direction of this accelerating torque as well as the restoring torque. That's going to be Ta is equal to Tr, right? This is going to be W by G K square alpha. That's going to be W R square theta by L we do have. So then from this one we are going to be calculating the alpha value. Alpha is equal to, what is the value from this one? The alpha is equal to W is going to be cancelled, G R square theta by L K square. That is going to be radius of variation. So once we are getting the alpha, so that in the similarly we are going to be calculating the K value. Once we are going to be getting the K value, so that I am going to be substituting in this I value. So in this case, alpha is equal to, we do have omega square into theta. So then once I am going to be substituting, omega square is equal to alpha by theta. That's going to be g r square theta by L k square. So in this case, and it is going to be theta we do have. So finally theta will going to be cancelled. From this equation, omega square is equal to g r square by L k square we got it. So this is the one formula, and the radius of variation k square is equal to g r square by L omega square. So by using this one, I am going to be substituting I is equal to, what is the formula? This is going to be mass moment of inertia is equal to W by G into k square, right? If once I am going to be substituting in this equation, that's going to be W by G, k square is equal to, what's the formula? G r square by L omega square. So G will going to be cancelled out. Then from this one, I is equal to W R square by L omega square we got it. So this way we are going to be calculating the mass moment of inertia. So that's I is equal to, what the formula? W. So that's going to be capital W R square by L omega square. This is called mass moment of inertia for circular disk.